morning, everybody. I'm Colin, the producer of Back to the Future, and we're here to celebrate Mr. Roger Bart's final show. The Winter Garden Theatre from the 30th of June. If you go to New York, you will see him, a wonderful new cast of Back to the Future. I'd like to thank all of you, particularly all the fans who we start to recognise. The show's now been seen by over 600,000 people, and it wouldn't be successful without all your dedication. So thank you for coming out tonight and celebrating. Welcome on the stage now, the man who created this show, Mr. Bob Dylan.
Thank you. Thank you very much. As a writer, one of my joys is hearing my dialogue performed the way I imagined. But the greater joy is when I hear my dialogue and see my scenes perform better than I could have done. And that is what this man does. Roger brings something to the stage beyond the page. He always finds a little nuance, an extra joke, a little bit of humanity, a touch of theater magic that just brings it on. Roger, you have made me, and I think you've made everybody here look way better than we really are. He's not only a terrific performer, he's a brilliant teacher. He is eager to share his knowledge and his experience with everybody in the cast, everybody backstage, all in the interest of making the show the best that it can be. Roger has never phoned it in. He never works on automatic pilot. He gives it all every show, and I am proud to call him my friend. Woo! He is leaving Doc Brown here in the very capable persona of the great Corey English. Corey is terrific, and as Colin said, Roger will be back on stage entertaining Broadway audiences the way he has entertained UK audiences for 520 shows. Wow. Everybody, give it up!
First of all, do I look fat? Okay, I'm just gonna make this really brief because you guys are standing and shit.
We love you!
I love you guys too so much. I'll get to that. I gotta tell you, I would not be here, obviously, without Bob's incredible story. It's just an amazing thing. I've always been in love with it. And Chris Lloyd's inspiration originally sort of was such a great launch point for me. I don't think that we would ever be here without Colin Ingram and his tenacity to get this done. Because it's really been a serious encounter on him so much for so many months, sort of lovingly trapped with my daughter in New Jersey. We had a blast, and she makes a good omelet now, but other than that, he really kept me in hope. And also, I have to thank just a couple of people. This theater, Andrew Lloyd Webber and the Nederlander Theater, has been an incredible home. The Adelphi Theater is an extraordinary place. And I'm very grateful to Madeline Lloyd Webber, who, against her better judgment, came up with on March 15th, when we open, and to take a peek at our show, and promised us that we could have this venue. And then 2 days later, everything shut down. So it's sort of extraordinary how much we owe to her and to Andrew Lloyd Webber, who was a champion of getting things open. So I'm feel very grateful to them. As you guys know, this is an incredible group of people. The former cast was incredible to work with. We also have, I know that that Ben is here and Justin are here, and they're my heroes and like my sons. You know? You know, none of this stuff happens. There's so many people behind the scenes. I know this is boring, but it means so much to me. There's so many people behind the scenes, stage management and the pits. You know, sometimes people say to me, "And what's it like doing the same thing every night?" I sing with a live orchestra every night. You know, it's the closest I'll ever be to being in U2. So, they're amazing. Every department in this building is extraordinary. And I just want to say, most of all, thank you to the fans of this show, which Bob has been so welcoming, and he taught me a lot about how to open our hearts to you, because you guys have really made this experience. This has been one of the greatest days of my life. So thank you so much. I just can't believe how much I love it here. And it's been mostly because of you, of the people of the United Kingdom. I just adore you. It's been a privilege to try to bring joy and escape to our lives from me to you guys. So thank you so much. I can't wait to come back.